we use the ladder theorem for proving the next one. So for any n times m system of linear equations, we have the following. If the solution is unique, then the number of columns is at most the number of rows. So at most the number of equations, since m is the rank of the matrix. Well, b, if we have a smaller number of equations than we have variables, then we have actually two cases. Either there are infinitely many solutions, or there are no solutions. We will illustrate this using the following example. Yeah, consider the next system. So basically we have four variables and three equations. So we have m, the number of columns, is smaller than the number of equations. Then we're in case b. So we have no solution, or we have infinitely many. Yeah, we could only have a unique solution if the rank of the matrix, the number of pivots, will be equal to the number of variables. But since a pivot, each pivot is on a different row, we need at least four of them, but we have only three rows. Well, look at the augmented matrix for this system, and we're gonna look whether we have no solution or infinitely many. So what we do is we calculate the reduced row echelon form for this matrix. As a first step, we start off with the one, and we're gonna sweep the minus 4 and 3 in the system, we'll make them 0 by adding 4 times row 1 to row 2 and subtracting 3 times row 1 from row 3. So we end up with the next augmented matrix. So 1 is the first pivot in the upper left part of the matrix. The next candidate pivot will be the element in the second row and the second column. Again, the row operations are just adding to the first and third one, 1 times the second row, we create the desired zeros. Yeah, look at the resulting matrix. Now we have two pivots, and we have on the third row we have a row of only zeros. So actually we're done with calculating the reduced row echelon form of the matrix AB. So what can we conclude? The conclusion is we do not have an inconsistent system, we have a consistent system. We have two pivots and one row of zeros. And actually we have two free variables. These are in the third and the fourth column. And so the free variables are the third and the fourth one. So how do we see this? Well, now we're going to look at some solution. We can see that actually the solution x is x1, x2, x3, x4, that x1 equals 2 plus 1 times the third variable minus 3 times the fourth variable, x4. x2 is 1 plus 1 times x3 minus 2x4. Well, we could freely choose x3 and x4, so we remain the values x3 and x4. So now we can split off a vector of constants, which is actually 2, 1, 0, 0, and a part that is depending on x3, which is x3 times the vector 1, 1, 1, 0. Plus x4 times minus 3 minus 2, 0, and 1. So we can write our solution, our complete solution to this system by some fixed vector, which is called the support vector, and two kind of direction vectors. So we see that in this way we end up with infinitely many solutions. For each value of x3 and x4 we have a different solution. And it looks like a parametric description of a solution, so we need two parameters to characterize this solution. The solution is therefore two-dimensional.